So today, as promised, I will be showing you some of my older photos, just because some of you actually have asked me if I could show my previous photos way back when my hair was shorter. So let's get started. I'm going to be flashing the photos right here. So all right, so here's the first one I'm going to be showing you guys, and this photo is actually on my emo days. I don't know if you guys have your emo days too, but this is me with shorter hair. This is actually a full bangs that I cut, but however, my bangs grew longer and I also just parted them to the side because it was just blocking my vision. So yep, that's it. All right, so now here is another angle of it, and it looks like this. And if you guys notice, my hair is actually quite thin at the bottom because I purposely made the hairdresser do this because my hair was layered on the front, and also it has a ton of layer at the back. And also the hairdresser really thinned out my ends because she said that it's gonna emphasize my layers even more if my hair was thinned out. This next photo, y'all can see that I do have the brown tints on my hair because I was just, in this time, I was actually experimenting to dye my hair, and I didn't dye it properly. It was just on that area to where like the color actually took place. So you can see like just on this side of my hair, it has brown tint. So yeah, that's it. So now, as you guys can see, my hair right here is apparently now growing. I feel like at this point I actually have a boob length hair. This is the point where I was trying to grow out my layers. Okay, so I'm gonna pop out more photos of my hair right here. And in this picture, I think I remember that at this point I was actually trying to even out my back, because before I used to have like a V-shape hairstyle on my hair and plus the layer. So this is the part where I'm kind of slowly just getting rid of the V-shape part of my back. And then next, fast forward, as you guys can see, the bottom parts of my hair is already straight. So at this point I actually remember that I finally got rid of my V-shape. This is the part where I kind of just like maintain the blunt cut at the back. This photo, as you guys can see, my hair grew a little bit longer. I feel like I have a rib length, like under the rib length hair. Point, this is the part where I started doing YouTube, and this is what my hair looked like before. So that's it. I'm gonna flash all photos right here. This is a photo of me and my sister. It's where my hair is curled, and we took kind of like a photo shoot when we were stranded. So what do you do when you get stranded? Of course you take pictures, you know, because why not? And also, as you guys can see right there, I don't really have that much layers anymore. And on this picture right here, I think this is my no heat crimp waves. And as you guys can see, my hair is finally kind of ish in one length. I still did have a few layers at the bottom part of my hair. All right, so now in this picture, you all would actually see the brown tints on my hair that, you know, I'm trying to grow out. They used to be like right here before, and now they're at the bottom. All right, so now here is the photo that I did with my cousin. This is like a photo shoot that we did back then. And my hair is actually to just like, I think like my hip bone. My hair didn't even hit butt length at this point yet. So fast forward, now my hair looks like this right here. That's it. This is kind of like my hair journey. It's what my hair looked like before and what my hair looks like now. I hope you guys like this video, because I know that some of you are actually curious to see what my hair looked like before, like, or what do I look like if I actually have shorter hair. So this is kind of like my sort of ish hair journey. So that is it. I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and I will see you on my next one. Bye.